The Mr. Excel podcast is brought to you by Easy Excel.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Okay, now in yesterday's episode, we took a look at how to use conditional formatting to highlight the lowest value in each row. And while I showed that in a seminar to answer the person's question, someone else in the seminar raised their hand and said, okay, wait, I have a different problem. I need to highlight the entire row for the item that has the highest average. So we want to look through all of these values over here in the average and highlight the entire row if we do that. So just like yesterday, we're going to pay attention to which cell is the active cell. The active cell here is cell H2. We'll create a new conditional formatting, new rule, use a formula to determine which cells to format. And this time, we want to look and see if column N of the current row, so equal $N, 2, the current row, that says we happen to be in row 2 right now as we're writing this formula, but because we don't put the dollar sign before the 2, it'll look at column N of each individual row and see if that's equal to the max of $N, $2, colon, $N, $14, get the whole value there. Let's see, format, we'll go with a nice green fill for the largest cell. Click OK, click OK. All right, so there is now highlighting the entire row of the value that's largest. Again, to test here, let's just put in large values straight across, 110, and Control Enter. And now that becomes the largest cell. So, a couple of different things. Yesterday, we talked about how to highlight the one cell in each row that was the lowest. Here, we're highlighting the entire row when this row is the largest of all the other rows. Both of these methods, using formula is, allows us to change the color of a cell based on other cells. Probably one of the more powerful versions of conditional formatting. So there you have it. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.